Thanks for passing by. Be sure to subscribe for more engaging content.
Everything is nonsense unless, or until, it's part of your own experience. Even then, it still might be an illusion. Watch, listen, and experience with discretion and perspective.
Today's topic is
struggles highly intelligent people suffer from.
Highly intelligent people are, on one hand, highly prized for their accomplishments, but at the same time ridiculed for their perceived social awkwardness. They see the world in a fundamentally different way than everyone else. Things that are obvious to them might be an alien mystery to the rest of the planet. Their very intellect, the thing that sets them apart, prevents them from really integrating into the rest of society. Here are some struggles highly intelligent people suffer from. They are under more pressure to succeed. Intelligent people feel like they must always be on top of their game, always perform to the absolute best of their capacity. When they don't, they feel like a failure. Because of this, they are often under stress to make sure that they don't slip. They are often worried about failure, and because of that, their stress level and anxiety can get quite high. They can see and understand things that people around them can't perceive. They become starkly aware of the direction their lives are headed and feel that it should head in a different direction than everyone else's. If anything they do doesn't contribute to being more successful, they feel like they are doing themselves a disservice. If their life doesn't take the path they think it deserves, they criticize and attack themselves. They find it harder to make friends. Intelligent people don't seem to really fit in or belong anywhere except with other intelligent people. They are not as graciously accepted as the free-spirited person in the group, or even the classic jokester. Intelligent people have a hard time just blending in and talking about the weather or sports or other random small topics. They struggle with small talk and find that people don't really get them when conversations starts going in a different direction, which for them, happens all too often. When intelligent people meet someone new, they ask clever, seemingly innocent questions that help them identify whether the person is someone worthy of their friendship. Even if a potential friend has much to offer or similar interests, an intelligent person may be quick to blow him or her off if the person doesn't display a level of insight into the world that matches theirs. This means intelligent people tend to be lonely. They suffer paralysis by analysis. Intelligent people like to be aware of all the pros and cons before making a decision. This can often stop them from making a decision altogether. That's because they overanalyze and let potential what-if scenarios get the better of them. This may also be because many intelligent people are perfectionists and just want to make sure they get the best possible result. They are trapped by their intelligence. There are several instances of intelligent people feeling helplessly trapped by their intelligence. For example, intelligent people don't typically have trouble understanding anything. If they attempt to teach someone and the person doesn't understand, they can't proceed. Additionally, others may resent intelligent people. Anything the intelligent person says sounds pretentious, when really, they're just stating the facts. This makes socializing unnecessarily hard. They find it harder to be happy. Intelligent people feel cursed by their intelligence. They often think about the saying, ignorance is bliss, and wonder if it would be better if they simply weren't so smart. But by pretending to not be intelligent, they feel like they're not being true to themselves. All the overthinking they do on a daily basis can lead to anxiety in social situations. Happiness comes from accepting the universe exactly as it is, but when you can't help but overanalyze the world around you, it's almost impossible to simply let yourself be absorbed by the imperfect beauty of what's around you. They find the opposite gender confusing. Because of a lack of practice in the social arena, they find the opposite gender intimidating and sometimes confusing. They just haven't been given enough practice interacting with the opposite gender, so people find them socially awkward. This tends to become a negative feedback loop as more and more less than optimal interactions pushes them further into solitude. Compound this with the desire to find someone as smart as they are so they can at least connect on a mental level, and they set themselves up for disappointment. They don't know how to have spontaneous fun. They don't just throw caution to the wind and live and let live, so to speak. Everything is analyzed, dissected and carefully thought or planned out. There is no random car rides to the beach for a day of fun. There are pros and cons to everything they do. They need to think things through. Because of this, random fun isn't something they engage in. As a matter of fact, it rarely happens at all. It's not because they don't want to have some, they just don't know how. They never just face danger in the name of fun. They can't just bravely explore or try something new and out there because they feel like it. Analyzing comes into play here again. They will think about something until they have literally talked themselves out of it. In their mind, it's not a good idea. Ever. If something is slightly dangerous, but still could be super fun, they will not even think about trying it because they think the danger will outweigh the fun.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the content, a like would be very appreciated.